सो हेलो एंड अ वेरी वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून यूट्यूब। सो फाइनली रमज़ान ख़त्म हुआ और अपन ईद वीद मना लिए एंड फाइनली टुडे आई गेट टू डू सम शूटिंग। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू बी शूटिंग एंड शोइंग यू गाइज ऑल द मॉड्स दैट आई हैव डन ऑन माई इंटरसेप्टर 650। दिस इज़ अ 2019 इंटरसेप्टर 650 ऑफकोर्स, वन ऑफ द फर्स्ट। एंड यू बीन फॉलोइंग द कस्टमाइजेशंस ऑन माई इंस्टाग्राम पेज। आई हैव quite heavily accessorized the bike and there's a separate video for the exhaust note. As you can see, it's a Gursevak exhaust right there. So the link for the exhaust note, if you're looking for an exhaust note, it's not there in this video. It's going to be in the link in the description. So anyways, without further ado, let's go ahead and first of all take a quick walk around of the bike. And yeah, as you can see, my studio is almost 90% ready. So our TV, wo sab aane ka hai. These nice forks and discs on the wall. And as you can see, my R1 is also standing right here. It's on the paddock. And all the helmets, oils, everything's nicely arranged. I got a new rack. And you can see some of my number plates from the old bikes. They're right there with some parts on top. And wahan pe bhi zara stator cover, tank, headlight of the ER6N. And couple of other awards and stuff here, followed by the jackets. And this rim is still a work in progress. So yeah, studio ka ek separate video rahega, but yep, let's move on to the walk around of the bike. So starting up front, I'll start off with what the genuine accessories which I got from Enfield themselves, which I bought from Enfield themselves. So this is the touring visor right here and the engine bash plate, which is down below. It's quite dirty because I was too lazy to clean it. And I got this crash guard also from Royal Enfield along with the fork gaiters. So of course, and complementing the entire look of the bike is this seat. It's a touring seat, but it doesn't belong to the Interceptor. It's a touring seat for the Continental GT. I really like the shape of this, and it also has a provision for a cowl, which I can add later on. So that gives the rear end of the bike a really good stance, as you can see. Now coming on to the indicators front and back, these are indicators from Thunderbird, the Royal Enfield Thunderbird. These are stock indicators from the Thunderbird and fitted into these mountings. These look really nice because the stock indicators of the bike are square and somehow they weren't fitting well with the bike, so I got that. So let's start off with what all I have done. Beginning from the front, the headlight unit, I didn't want to change it to an LED. Of course, you can do that if you want to retrofit a Thunderbird one or any aftermarket ones. I don't want to do this because I need visibility on the highway. So Osram Nightbreaker Laser HD bulbs in the headlight, followed by two Auxbeam auxiliary lamps. These are really, really nice and powerful and well focused. I focus them away from the bike, as you can see, because they're supposed to focus on the corners where I can see the dividers and other stuff on the sides of the road pretty clearly. I don't want to blind the opposite person. That's not my intention. Now, moving on, the biggest thing people have been asking me about this year is Boss Audio MC470B audio system. The amplifier is right there underneath the side panel, and yep, it's a 1000 watts unit. All the wiring and everything, of course, on the bike has been done by me. So as you can see, there are no exposed wires anywhere. It's got a lot of wiring, trust me, three relays and fuse junctions and whatnot. But yep, so two speakers on the handlebar and two speakers on the crash guard. So the crash guard is really nice and aesthetic. It's, you know, after fitting all the accessories, it kind of chup jata. So yep, that's there. And this is a really nice aluminium waterproof switch which I got from AliExpress. So this is for the system and this is for the auxiliary lamps. I can connect a set of other lights also. The switches part is going to control that later on. And the view of the meter is not really obstructed when I'm riding. Har cheez clearly dikhti meko. This little RAM mount, it's also from AliExpress. And yep, that's much of it for the cosmetic. And yep, the exhaust. And yep, the exhaust, of course, it's a Gursevak unit. I got it from Delhi. 19,500 was the cost. And of course, all the accessory names and links, whatever possible, or the prices are mentioned in the description below. So yep, this is the brushed metal finished one. You also get a chrome finished one. I'm not a chrome person, so yeah, I got this because it's really bassy, nice sounding and not that loud. And I've removed the rear grab rail along with the entire sari guard assembly because no one's gonna sitting on my bike. Because no one's gonna be sitting on my bike with a sari. And of course the grab rail was kind of looking out of place with the seat and everything. The bike I feel kind of looks a lot more aesthetic now. So yep, very minimalistic and aesthetic, just the way I like it. I have to wait for a nice LED tail lamp unit. It's still not here yet, nobody's providing it. And a little bit of stickering on the shocks and all. And yes, now moving on to the engine. I've not done any major mods to the engine, but yes, what I felt is the oil which is given by Royal Enfield, it's manufactured by HP, and not really the best of oils considering Enfield considers a 10,000 kilometer service interval. So I don't think that oil would last that much. Of course, the company knows a lot, I know, but there is also something called cost cutting. So you have to be aware of that. So I have switched to Motul 7100. That's 15 20W50, I'm not sure, but yep, it's the matching grade what the company recommends. I didn't mess around with the grades, but yeah, it's a fully synthetic 7100. No need to use 300V on this bike because it's a racing oil and this is not a racing bike, as you know. So 7100 will do just fine. In fact, it'll do just better because it does have the cleaning agents and other additives. Also, I have changed the spark plugs, so NGK CR8 EIX plugs on this. There was a lot of confusion. People were like, CR9 dalna hai, CR8 dalna. So please don't mess around with the heat ranges. The right heat range of spark plugs for this bike is 8. So you better stick with CR8 EIX. It's mentioned on some UK websites internationally. So yep, the plugs and the engine oil have made a really huge difference on the bike. Rides very smoothly now, doesn't overheat that much. Even the stock, the company engine oil, it kind of used to heat up a little bit in traffic, but with this oil I don't really feel anything, and it runs much smoother. And vibrations hai nahi gaadi mein, but still it still feels more smoother. You have a huge difference with this oil, especially on the highway. And the plugs, they reduce the engine braking. Overall zara feel achhi hoti gaadi ki. No, it's not going to drastically increase your power or anything as such. Zara riding experience thoda smooth aur achha ho jata. And yeah, apart from that, also the horn has been changed on the bike. So as you can see right here, hidden here is the Denali sound bomb horn along with the Denali harness. Of course, the wiring done by me. So let's just go ahead. Firstly, I'll show you the horn and then we'll move on to the audio system of the bike. So it's quite loud. It's very loud. Damn, that's loud. So now let me show you guys the audio system. Of course, the mic is not going to do much justice to catch it, but trust me, 4 units, 1000 watts, it is insanely loud and insanely clear. A lot more than what I expected for this bike. So let me just fire it up. So yes, I do have some really really dank songs in my phone, but we're not going to mess around with the copyright stuff. So let me just put up something nice for you guys, which is not copyright protected. You can see it's got a really nice volume control here. I mounted it over there. This is good. yep, that's about it for my short walk around of the bike. That is pretty much the mods I've done. What is upcoming? Yes, the LED tail lamp, and I might be going in for the alloy wheels from Royal Enfield because I don't want to put any aftermarket ones and take that risk. So yep, those two are the probably the only upgrades, and maybe a little bit of a color change, a custom painted tank and the front and rear mudguards to be painted black because I love black. And yes, I have to get ceramic coating also done on this bike because yep, Enfield keys are paint quality thodi thank you hai. The, you know, kind of a lot of scratches I noticed on the bike, swirl marks and all that. So, thoda bahut to rehta hi isna bhai. For this price, you're getting an extremely good bike. But, thoda jagah pe thoda dekh lena padta. We cannot really complain that much. But, yep, that's about it. And yes, I also removed this rear plastic piece. Thodi bahut kichad uchalti, but it really improves the aesthetics of the bike. And do drop your comments and let me know what you guys think about the bike. And also, if you guys want me to put any other mods on this bike, of course, it's a crazy bike. I'm having a great time in the city, on the highway, and the mileage front and everything, the system, everything works so perfectly. Now, I know the two biggest questions everyone's gonna ask. One, won't so many electronics put a load on the battery? No, the alternator on this bike generates 160 watts. At idle RPM, or you know, 1200-1500 RPM, whatever it's in the manual, and I feel that's more than enough to power most of the stuff in this bike. So 12 volt 160 watts, not bad. And till now I've been riding with the system. It's been more than 3 months since I got the bike, almost. Yeah, March mein mili thi. So never faced any battery drain issues or anything as such. It's perfect. Only thing, I think batteries are jaldi haath ko aati, ek saal ki jagah shayad 6-8 महीने में हाथ को आएंगी, but that's something I can live with. And I use the LED lamps. They are very bright, very powerful. Let me just show them. दिन का टाइम है तो महसूस नहीं होते, but yes, these are very bright. You can see. अभी भी ऑन ऑफ करे तो जरा कितना फर्क पड़ रहा है दिन के टाइम भी. सो या दैट एंड द म्यूजिक सिस्टम, एंड ऑल्सो आई गो माई वे हॉन्किंग ऑन द हाईवे, बट नेवर येट हैव आई फेस्ड एनी लैग और एनी फीलिंग दैट द बाइक्स इलेक्ट्रिक्स आर फेलिंग और एनीथिंग, बिकॉज ऑल द वायरिंग इज डन बाई मी, सेपरेट रिले, सेपरेट फ्यूजेस, सेपरेट सर्क्यूट्स फॉर एवरीथिंग. एंड सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, what does this do to my warranty? Well, quite frankly, I don't care, because gaadi leke first service tak I was on the stock oil, and uske baad bhi almost 1500 kilometers, like 2500 in total, ab tak to gaadi 4000 chal gayi. So 2500 kilometers I rode on the stock oil and everything, kyunki kuch bhi agar problem rehna hai gaadi mein to shuru ke 2-3000 kilometer mein aa jana chahiye, and with the quality Enfield is giving, I don't think isme kuch problem aana chahiye. So after that I switched to the better engine oil and all this stuff, and of course warranty ke zara rules apne paas badalna, because as long as you don't mess with the stock circuits or stock anything of the bike, it should be fine. Sub aftermarket piggyback lagawa hai iske upar, so that shouldn't be a problem. But you know, this is India, yahan pe bas sabko reason hona rehta. Apne paas kya hai, tire puncture ho gaya, bole to engine oil ki wajah se hua, sab bolte loga. So I don't really care about the warranty, and it's an Enfield boss. Kuch bhi hua kara to, you know, kafi saste mein parts replace bhi ho jate hain, unlike this little bad baby here. So yep, वारंटी का थोड़ा रहता, बट आई एम श्योर मोस्ट ऑफ यू कैन लिव विद इट. उतना सीन नहीं है, बस वारंटी का सोच लेते बड़े तो गाड़ी फिर कंपनी से निकाले ऐसी चलाना पड़ता. एंड इनफैक्ट द मॉड्स वी हैव डन, द इंजन ऑयल प्लग्स, एवरीथिंग टू द इंजन, इट्स एक्चुअली हेल्पिंग द इंजन ब्रीद एंड रन बेटर. आफ्टर मार्केट एयर फिल्टर इज ऑल्सो इनकमिंग, वो भी आने वाला है. तो एनफील्ड इफ एनी थिंग शुड टेक क्यूज फ्रॉम मी. सो या दैट्स अबाउट इट फॉर माई शॉर्ट वीडियो. होप यू गाइज एन्जॉयड वॉचिंग, एंड होप आई डेंट मिस आउट ऑन एनी थिंग. And hopefully zara videos regular karenge ab. And do drop in your comments if you guys want any other more informative videos or any in-depth video on any other accessory which I have on my bike, and I will make it. So thank you so much for watching, and bye bye.